So today I've come back again, right? And I will be explaining from page 14 till page 15. So it's the continuation of the same chapter all about a dog. So last time I had sent you all that PDF and I hope you all are referring to it because some of you might not have the textbooks with you all. So please go through that PDF and it is the content I had sent, the chapter content there. Alright, so I'm continuing from page 14 where I had left last class. So we find that there's a chaos in the bus, alright, because of the dog which a woman was carrying along with her. So the bus conductor, he was into some mischief and he did not want that lady to carry the dog. So we find that he was immovable, as cold as the night and as hard as the pavement. She passed on in a fury of importance to the three policemen who stood like a group of statuary up the street watching the drama. So the conductor had called the policemen also. Alright, so they also came up to the street and they were all in a group and they were just watching the drama which was happening there. Then she came back imperiously. Imperiously means in a way that shows you accept people to obey you. So she wanted that conductor to show some respect to her. But since the conductor was very, very ill-mannered, so she felt very bad. Then she came back imperiously, beckoned to a young man who had a silent witness of her rage and vanished. So there was the narrator himself in the bus, right? And he did not say anything. He was just keeping quiet. Others followed. So all the passengers who were there, who had boarded that bus, they were all quiet and they started following the lady. The bus was emptying. That means all the people, all the passengers in the bus, they got down from the bus. Even the dashing young fellow who had demanded the number and who had declared he would see this thing through if he sat there all night. So even the, even the young fellow, the narrator of the story, he was also there. So he also did not speak anything, he did not say anything, so he just got down, had taken an opportunity to slip away. So even he wanted to run away from there. Meanwhile, the Pick and Zee party were passing through every stage of resistance to abject surrender. Abject means terrible and without hope. So they were all hopeless, alright, they did not have any hope. Because they knew that this lady had to be out of the bus because she could not travel with the dog. "I'll go on the top," said the skill-skin lady at last. So she said that she was ready to go on to the roof top of the bus. "You mustn't." So her friend, she asked her not to go. "I will," but she was determined that she would go on the rooftop of the bus. "You will have pneumonia." So a friend said that do not go on to the rooftop because you might fall sick. "Let me take it. This is this from the man." So she was angry with the conductor and she said that she was ready to take the disease also. "Certainly not. She would die with a dog." So some of her friends said that she would die in the cold along with the dog. So children, I hope you all are understanding. When she had disappeared up the stairs, the conductor came back, pulled the bell and the bus went up. So when she went out of the bus and she went off to the rooftop of the bus, the conductor, he came inside, he pulled the bell and the bus started moving. He stood sorely triumphant, so he was very, very happy. He felt that he had won the war. While his conduct was savagely discussed in his face by the remnant of the party. Remnant means what was left. So, though he was very happy from inside, but his expressions showed that he was not very, very happy with what had happened. Then the engine stuck work. So, the engine, the bus, it stopped. And the conductor went to the help of the driver. So, while the bus was moving, suddenly the bus stopped, alright. And the conductor, he got down and went to help the driver. It was a long job, and presently the lady with the dog stole down the stairs and re-entered the bus. So while the conductor and the bus was looking after the problem, for the bus to stop, this lady, she got down from the rooftop quietly, all right, and she came and sat inside the bus again. When the engine was put right, the conductor came back and pulled the bell. So when the engine was all right, so the conductor came back again, right, and he gave the signal for the bus to start. Then his eye fell on the dog. So when the bus started again, so he again saw the lady along with the dog. And his hand went to the bell rope again. So again, he wanted to stop the bus. The driver looked around. So the driver was confused. He did not know what to do. So he just looked around. The conductor pointed to the dog. So the conductor wanted to tell the dog that the dog was there. That's why he did not want the bus to start. The bus stopped. Again, the bus stopped. And the struggle recommenced. Recommenced means it started. Again, there was confusion. Again, there was chaos inside the bus because of the dog. With all the original features, the conductor walking down the pavement. So again, he stopped the bus because he did not want the bus to move on. So again, what he did was that he got down from the bus, he stopped the bus, all right, and he started walking on the road, telling that the bus would not move until and unless the lady was not there inside the bus with a dog. The driver drumming his fingers. So even the driver, he was insisted not to drive. So he did not know what to do. So he just started playing drums in his steering wheel. The little dog blinking at the lights. So the poor little dog, who did not have anything to do, was just sitting on his master's lap and he was just blinking his eyes. The sealskin lady declaring that she would not go on the top, and finally going. So what happened? She knew that the conductor was very, very rude, all right, and she would not let the bus move, isn't it? So she finally decided to go to the rooftop again. "I've got my rules," said the conductor to me. So the conductor, he went and started talking with the narrator. To me, me in this line is the narrator himself who was traveling in the bus. "When I was the last passenger left behind," so all of them got down, and this narrator was the only one who was left behind in the bus. So the conductor came and spoke to him. He had won his victory, so he was very, very happy, right, because he felt that he had won. The conversation or the drama with that woman with whom he had a fight, but felt that he would like to justify himself to somebody. So he wanted to justify things. "Rules," I said. So the narrator started talking to this conductor. "Are necessary things." So he wanted to explain to the conductor, saying that rules are very, very important, isn't it? If you do not follow rules, what will happen? You become a bad human being or disorganized person. So he said that rules are very, very necessary. But there are rules and rules. So those rules are only meant to be rules. "Some are hard and fast rules." So the narrator was explaining to the conductor, saying that there are rules, but some are hard and some are fast. Like the rules of the road. So on the road, there are some rules, isn't it? You aren't supposed to cross when there's a traffic. You're supposed to walk on the zebra crossing. So all those are rules which are to be followed on the road, which cannot be broken without danger to life. So you cannot break down the rules of the road, because that would end your life. but some are rules only for guidance. So he wanted to explain to the conductor saying that some rules are there only to guide you, which you can apply or wink at. So you can apply those rules on your life or you can just leave them. As a common sense dictates, like the rule about the dogs. So he wanted to give an example saying that the rule which this conductor had, that he should not let any passenger come along with a dog. So that is just the rule which he had made himself, isn't it? They are not a whip put in your hand to scrouge your passengers with. So actually, you're not supposed to put those rules, hard and fast rule, for your passengers. So that was what he was trying to tell the conductor. But an authority for an emergency. So that is just an authority for yourself, for your safety. They are meant to be observed in the spirit, not in the letter, for the comfort and not the discomfort of the passengers. So he said those rules were only meant for yourself, to keep it to yourself, but not to harass anybody, right? Especially the passengers who travel in the bus. You have kept the rule and broken its spirit. So the narrator said to the conductor, saying that you have your rules, but you've not followed it properly. You want to mix your rules with a little good will and good temper. So he said that if you really want to follow, imply the rules on your passengers, you need to be good to them. You should not be very rude and harsh with your passengers. He took it very well. So the conductor, he understood what the narrator wanted to tell him. And when I got off the bus, he said good night quite amiably. So he was the last passenger to get down from the bus. Right, and when he was getting off the bus, the conductor, he said good night to this narrator in a very different way, feeling that it felt as if the narrator was sorry for himself. So children, I have finished with the chapter, so please read it once again, and I will be sending you your question answers in the next class. Thank you.